今天是一个合堂，所以我们要欢迎从英文堂来的。Today we have a combined service, so we have our brothers and sisters from English congregation. Maybe we can welcome them. Can the English congregation stand up? Yeah. So I'll see how many of them. Praise the Lord.Praise the Lord. Okay. You may be seated. Today, this 崇拜是我们每一年在夏令退休会的时候我们有在主的面前一同在本堂聚集的时间。这段时间我们愿意看见每一位都能够从神的话语里面继续得到帮助。我们有很多弟兄姐妹在营会所以我们有这样的机会一起有一个联合的聚会。Because the summer retreat, we have many brothers and sisters in Sonoma College. Now we're going to spend time together. So the message will try to serve different need in different way. But most importantly, the message is for us to be touched in our spirit, not just to gain knowledge, not even to edify our spiritual life.Because that's a consequence of our piety before God. So we need to, first of all, center on what God had in mind for us today. 我们今天是不在这个地方我们读的这一段经文我们等一下要稍微再打一下的英文我把它简单的叫legacy, 就是有一个生命的托付承传下去一代又一代我们传承是神在我们身上的一个作为要从一代又一代要诉说这事 Now legacy means passed on the seems that the Lord deposited in our heart with a strong conviction in us, and we like to pass on to another generation, another generation. Today we're going to read scripture again, so you're going to see if you are English speaking, the 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1. 我儿啊，你要在基督耶稣的恩典上刚强起来。This is in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1. You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace and that is in Christ Jesus. 在保罗这个时刻，他已经在人生的最后，他要传递什么信息给他的属灵的儿子提摩太呢 This is pretty much to the end of Apostle Paul's life, and he had something to say to Timothy, his true beloved son. So now we're going to just meditate this verse first. 让我们一同来看这一段经文的时候，我们想想看。保罗他没有说你穿得软吃得饱你现在有什么问题你牧养教会的时候有什么困难他没有讲这些他讲到了只是告诉你必须在基督耶稣里这是保罗服事的重点 就是必须在耶稣基督里面，否则那样的恩典虽然神给了，我们并没有完全的得到，这是非常可惜的。他要提摩太在这一个基督耶稣的恩典，什么叫做在基督耶稣里面，就是只有我们这个人承认我们自己不是撒旦的对手，我们必须要来到神的面前，我们必须进入耶稣基督这样的一个祝福中。So the Apostle Paul, he decided to tell Timothy these things that is in Christ Jesus, that's the central message. That Paul never wanted anything to overshadow that major thing is Christ Jesus is the center. And in Christ means anything else outside of Christ.We're not less. And the grace the Lord already gave to us. Yet, that grace needs to be actualized in our life. We need to be in Jesus Christ. And in Him, we will be strengthened. Our faith will be strengthened. Our testimony will become magnified to people that not yet believe.And also to the community, that Christian and Jewish community that times, they will see what a wonderful Lord Jesus Christ gave the grace that include his life and every good things. He blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. From Jesus Christ and in him, we are saved now throughour own hard work, not through the good deeds, but through the grace of God. 我们继续看第二句，保罗要讲的是什么呢？他是非常注重教导。他说你在许多见证人的面前，所听见我所教训的这些，也要交托那忠心能够教导别人的人。这就是我们今年整个教会是要做一个门徒的训练，要带出门徒，也就是说我们有一个教导就是神的话是所有一切教导的根基我们绝对不能脱离神的话，绝对不能脱离圣经。圣经是神设立让教会能够按照圣经所指示的蓝图能够成为耶稣基督的心腹。 And Paul just mentioned something very important. After we receive the grace of God in Jesus Christ, and we need to teach others the most important thing is the Bible.It's none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. He's incarnated through those Old Testament's prophecy. And also realized in the New Testament. And the Lord wants us to just pass down the Word of God as a foundation for everything, particularly to church.So the church will be the bride of Jesus Christ when he shall return to receive us unto himself on that day. And we're going to see that glorious church without any stain or blemish. It's a holy church set apart for God's purpose. And we will be there. That's the exciting part. And we see Apostle Paul, even though he faced death, butHe is so focused. 所以我们看见在使徒保罗的一生中，到了最后的时候，他还是最集中的几件事情，就是第一个，刚才我们讲到的是集中在耶稣基督身上；第二个，就是在神的话语这是绝对不能妥协的我们继续再看下去的时候遵行神的话语。我们在生活中间，我们就遇见了必须接受苦难 啊，因为啊，这里讲到是一个精兵的问题，啊，这里讲到是一个啊，我们在世上啊真实的状况，是在与仇敌撒旦魔鬼阴府的权势征战的一个重要的点上，啊，我们是蒙召当兵的，啊，也就是说在征战中间啊，没有人啊可以啊随意啊。必须有一个元帅在带领，必须有一个方向，必须有训练，必须被装备，且必须勇敢，必须明白仇敌的诡计，然后才能够在征战中间得胜。这是保罗就讲到苦难是不可以缺乏的，不可以缺少的。有谁到最后的时候愿意讲这些话呢？我不晓得你跟你的孩子们讲什么话，我们训练我们的孩子是否也是如此呢？是否愿意他们要经过一些约束经过一些他不喜欢的事情但是对他是长久有益处的最近这个年轻人他们有这个团契他们也有有很多的在一起的交流他们也希望我们能够向父母们说一些话今天他们有一些坐在这里所以向父母说什么话呢就是我们教导孩子究竟是什么是最重要的如果你在当兵的时候是什么是最重要的打仗没有人要决定打败的一定要做一个打胜的人这是非常重要的在属灵的征战中间要得胜要必须需要在生命的苦难中间与神有份否则因为我们这个人是死在罪恶败坏中我们的肉体天然不是撒旦的对手这点我们需要清楚于是我们教导我们的孩子的时候是用我们的生命来教导这是一个生命的功课我不晓得大家对这个生命的功课有没有在家里面就开始操练还是我们的孩子们根本看不见我们是基督的精兵这是一个非常重大的一个问题 Now as we come to this stageMany of us as parents have children, also we try to teach our children. But the content or the emphasis or the concentration of our teaching, may I ask, is a focus on Jesus Christ. He called us to be the testimony on this earth. And we are against the principality and the power.And the evil darkness overpower us, or we overcome them. And nobody plan to fight a battle and fail. And we decide that we are going to be the soldier of Jesus Christ. We prepare ourselves to endure the hardship. What do you mean by endure the hardship? Because our flesh, our carnality is so easily make us to pursue the worldly things and the vainglory and also accumulate the wealth, whatever, work hard in our career at the expense of neglecting the family. From children's perspective,They have a clear vision, perception to see whether we truly are the mighty soldier, a good soldier for Jesus Christ or not. That is important. So Paul decided to tell Timothy that you will share in suffering with me. Actually, it's not with the Apostle Paul.Share this suffering with the Lord Jesus Christ. He suffers through his life. He obey God until death and death on the cross. Now, Apostle Paul decide that he is going to use several illustrations. I'll get back to that. 当保罗讲到要当基督的精兵的时候，他用了几个比喻，第一个，我们要看见的就是我们是在军中当兵的，不以事物缠身，好叫那召我们当兵的人喜悦。好，我不晓得我们中间有多少是当兵的，最近我在陪师母走路的时候也有碰到一位，他是因为他的女儿住在我们那个社区，所以他在那里然后他就来跟我们打招呼，我当然很热情地跟他打招呼，他就跟我说，他说我是从中国来的那我说你这么年轻怎么就退下来了？他说我是当兵的，当了30多年了是。那我说那时候当兵是很经过筛选，很不容易的的确是如此，他们两夫妇都是当兵的所以我看见他们的身体状况都非常好而且他们结束了以后他们在这个军中在中国解放军中这样的服侍以后他们就来享受他们跟孙辈们在一起的时光，很感谢主。后来我就想到我们中间也有不少是当过兵的但是有没有人想过我们每一位都是当兵的？你每一位都是在神的国里面做当兵的如果今天你真的知道你是当兵的那就需要知道几件事情，不将事物缠身。有没有事物是缠着我们让我们不能听神的话不愿意把最好的给主，因为他是我们的主，他有所有的一切祝福都在我们的顺服中，他将我们圈在顺服的篱笆里面，将祝福全部的倾倒在其中。如果我们不顺服，我们的日子就会非常非常的艰苦，因为以别神代替耶和华的，我们的愁苦就必增添所以我们需要知道不能被世上的事情缠住但是有很多人说，你知道我们是在 Silicon Valley 我们这里是工作很忙的怎么能够不被事物缠身其实不是时间上的，乃是心态上的。我们的主是否他在你的生命中间永远是居第一位这是最重要的。我们信主的时候，我们决定的这一件事情就会带领我们日后的路走得对走得不对就在乎这里了怎么知道主在第一位呢就是你凡事要讨他的喜悦，这是保罗所说的，我已经立了志向，凡事要讨主的喜悦今天我们需要在立志这一方面要刚强起来。我们很多的时候我们感情很丰富了一听见一些的故事泪流满面好像看电影一样非常感动，以后呢对你生命的影响并没有很大立志却不一样，他立定坚定的这个志向的时候他是越挫越勇是不被任何的事情所牵引被引动这个失去福音的盼望失去对主的依靠这是非常重要的如何能够立志讨主的喜悦，这是 你我要立的志向中间第一要紧的没有比这更重要的。 No soldier get entangled in the civilian pursuit seems his end is to please the one who enlisted him. every one of us here were enlisted in the army of Jesus Christ. If you're not, today you may be enlisted. The Lord called us to fight this battle courageously. The life struggle with our flesh. Only through cross, when Jesus Christ, he took up the cross, means he obeyed his Father all the way until he been crucified on it. And he decided that those who follow him will take up the cross and follow him. There's no other way that we can know for sure that we already determined to follow the Lord. To decide, that's our number one priority, that the Lord's pleasure and his smile, his joy is the number one things in your life. If you make that decision, you can be sure God will be glorified. As a result, you will receive all the blessing, just like you've been surrounded by a boundary, a fence, within those Lord's blessed dominion. And Lord's power, Lord's authority is going to defeat the enemy for sure. If we are outside of the protection of Lord's protective arena, I will be defeated. So let's make sure that there's one thing in our life. We really want to not depend on the feeling, not depend on how hard we work, but depend on the decision we determined in our volition to place Christ first and to please him in everything we do. If you do that, if I do that, even though we are weak, even though sometimes we just felt that we are powerless, but in actuality, the Holy Spirit will strengthen us. That's what the Paul is trying to say. And then he used another one. That's next one. 他又用了另外一个比喻，这个比喻跟当兵也很像是做一个比喻这个比喻是来到神的面前，好像在竞技，好像在运动中得到力量一样。我不晓得我们有多少人喜欢在运动中，在打仗里面输掉的。刚才讲到在打仗中有一个条件，就是不被事物缠身，然后我们的心智坚定，然后我们顺服主然后我们认清敌人，我们来作战这是比赛的规则。你如果不照这个规则不能够得胜的那我们今天这样的一个竞技是怎么样来看的呢？现在是 Olympic 的时间，我们有很多人很注意的，对不对注意什么呢注意到将来拿牌最多的可能数量上最多的可能是中国拿金牌最多的有可能是美国我们两边都有两边都加了一些很多但第一开始第一天中国没有拿到金牌为什么没有拿到？本来有一位孙杨他在自由式蝶泳这一个领域中他在1000多此的这个比赛中这个他是世界冠军，在1000多米这是一个体力跟技术跟毅力这样综合在一起他是世界纪录的保持人。但是昨天比较的是只有400米曾经有这么样的一个机会我们不晓得 是不是对的啊？他有一个对手，这个对手是澳大利亚，这个人跟他非常靠近，在这一个比较短程的中间是非常靠近的结果最后孙杨以0.13秒败落，0.13秒败落了所以他拿到银牌。但是我相信在这个长城的时候他是会赢的。因为我们跑也好，我们跑熟天的路不是看前面是看最后是如何愿神帮助我们，让我们真正知道这个竞技不是当时凭着血气之勇就可以，而是平常有不间断的锻炼这是我们需要知道的。 Now the second illustration, poor use is athletic competition, and we are excited about the Olympic, and now it's just a beginning and a starting point, and we're going to see many medals from those athletes. It's exciting to have the golden medal or silver medal. Gold medal, when you have it, that means nobody in this time, on this earth, in this particular competition, they can overpower you. We are so glad that China and America, they all have many of those competent, competitive, and powerful athletes. We have Sun Yang recently, and he competed in freestyle swimming 400 meter, and he lost to one from Australia, and we call him Mac Horton by 0.13 seconds. We feel so bad. But don't worry, he got a silver medal. None of us got yet. But I'm sure he will have a gold medal later in the competition. That will be a longer range. It's next Saturday. Sometimes we got the earlier victory. We just get too carried away, and we are out of ourselves, and we just forgot. We still need to finish and finish well. With the long range competition, the beginning winning doesn't guarantee. At the end, you're going to get the prize, the award. So today, I would like to just trying to contemplate what Paul is trying to say. You know, he just want the people to compete in the arena as an athlete. He will receive a crown if he practice, if he decide to discipline himself, also according to the rule. Some people been disqualified because they violate the rule. And what's the rule for a Christian soldier, Christian athlete? It's to place Jesus Christ number one place in our life. If we decide to do that, we have opportunity to win. Okay, let's quickly get into number six. Many of us are not a soldier. Many of us didn't think we are the Christian soldier. None of us felt that we can compete in Olympic level. But this one, I'm going to just explain to you. Everyone will feel very close to it. 我们不是每一个人都可以做军人、做打仗我们也不是每一个人都是 啊，在这个竞技中啊，在啊这个竞赛中啊可以得名。但是啊，保罗他用了另外一个啊非常好的，他是用一个农夫啊，农夫啊，农夫是什么呢？啊，是哦，他在劳苦的工作中，他有一个最大的期盼，就是收成。啊，我不晓得啊，有没有农夫他种了以后说，我不管会不会收成，根本就不重要啊！这就是我们中国人常说的“只问耕耘，不问收获”。啊，可能你的孩子会告诉你说：“哎呀，你只要耕耘就好了，不要管收获啊！你也不要想从我身上收什么。”真的是这样。如果父母要想从孩子身上收什么，可能会非常的失望啊！啊，为什么呢？因为使他生长的是神啊！今天我们需要知道，农夫他是忍耐等候啊，这个收成的时候啊，所以保罗真正的想到了，就是说，不管啊，你再勇猛啊，军人啊，再会啊，这个啊，把啊，这个竞赛啊做得很好，了解这个竞赛的啊，要用什么样的规矩？但是如果啊，你不是能够忍耐等候神的时候，啊，很可能在这场征战中你无法得胜。啊，你们可以想一想，我们的忍耐怎么样？啊？昨天有一个婚礼啊，啊，今天他们因为还有很多客人从世界各地来，所以他们啊没有办法来。他就是 Howard 跟 Sarah Chan 啊，张玉浩啊，他们啊，前啊上个礼拜还在我们英文堂聚会。他们结婚啊，太太是韩国人啊，先生啊是啊。我从小就认识他的父亲，他那时候这个到世界各地去了他父亲带着他到各个地方去，然后一直到30几岁了才结婚，所以人家都问他的父亲说你儿子是不是第一次结婚啊？因为他36岁，他说不是，真的没有啊，那他也是等候了啊很久哈，但是在这个整个婚礼里面很短的时间，因为我们在Los Gatos 那个长老会我们有那天因为是女家是韩国人所以韩国人来了很多，所以大概有500人参加婚礼是一个蛮大的婚礼。然后他们站在台上的时候没有冷气，没有像我们这边那么好然后就冒汗了，两个人都在那么冒汗我没有让他们站很久我讲的很短非常的短不是像现在，因为你们有冷气有一些人也在训练忍耐，这是一种训练忍耐训练一下今天很早你们就可以出去了，我们又不吃饭你们可以去吃很好的这个食物可能等一下的时候有一些很好的餐馆，你还要跑快一点，不然都被我们的会友抢了特别又是这个中国人讲父亲节他是用一个月的8月，整个8月都是父亲节他们用88节我说没关系我们讲天父是全年都是的就是所有的每一天都是我们天父的你们不阿们阿们都是天父的所以今天我们可以真的很高兴庆贺一下他们两个在那里的时候我们就讲了爱是很久忍耐我一看他们有反应因为他们要忍耐要他不是忍耐彼此，他们就希望快点结束忍耐今天我们种田的劳力的农夫欲速则不达很多人揠苗助长 没有办法让一些东西完成的啊，必须啊按照啊神的时间，因为使他生长的是神，所以我们要忍耐。我们做成的什么事啊，不是我们自己拿出来夸耀啊，拿出来啊这个给人家知道我们很能干，哎，完全不是这样的事情啊。我们做什么事情需要知道这是神的恩典在你我每一个人身上，所以这就是生命成熟的表现啊。神不会亏待殷勤劳苦的人，所以这边讲的你当先得粮食啊，所以你会得到神的祝福，那是最好的祝福啊，是必须把我们啊有的啊交托给啊主。Now we're going to come to one illustration, the last one, is to be the farmer, not just to be the soldier or athlete, but farmer. Farmer, this one thing inspires me most.As they work hard, but they anticipate to reap the harvest. So the problem is you want to reap immediately. That's not possible. There's a time to plan and a time to wait and a time to reap and a time to enjoy the harvest. That's why we have those different seasons.So we called, we are seasoned Christian. Means we go through a season, a period of time, until we receive the blessing from God. And that requires patience. So patience is a virtue. Yesterday we have the wedding, Howard and Sarah.Chen. They now husband and wife. Sarah was Korean. Howard's father I knew for a long time. Actually, baptized Howard's grandma just about 7 years ago. So we knew this family well. And when they lay down.Something on the altar. It's not just before God, but to each other, but also to the humanity, that they will be a channel of blessing to others. That's the whole message. You need to be patient to do that. Otherwise,You know, we just spoil God's plan. By design, they wait for many years. Howard was 36. So people ask the father, your son's first marriage? Is this the first one? And that's a good question. Nowadays, you know, everyone wants to wait until proper time to get married.But once they find the right person, then they need to be patient and work until the harvest. So the harvest will come. Wedding is just the beginning. And the marriage is going to last for a lifetime, intended for enjoyment, intended for benefit.Fisher to one another. We all recipient of grace. We also need to bless each other with the virtue God gave to us. The life is very important. So Apostle Paul, he used this common one as a farmer, wait patiently, and he will have the first share of the crops.And you have a garden. You've been waiting for very long. In some church at this time, they have the harvest. They bring all those good stuff from their garden to the church. And anyone can take whatever we didn't have. And also to give what we have the surplus for. But the first share of the crop belong to the one who labor. That's fair. If we work so hard and get nothing, that's not fair. But how many of us thought that, you know, we just did everything for the Lord and get nothing? Well, don't express. Some young people told me that, you know. Well, we worked so hard, you know, we tried everything, you know, in school, and we come to the church, you know, because our parents compelled us to come and also want us to remember the scripture verses, and we worked so hard and didn't benefit anything yet. But you need to be patient. And patience is a virtue. All right, the last two. All of those things you need to meditate. 我所说的话你都要听，每一句话都要听，因为凡事主必给你聪明。意思是什么呢？保罗他是有权威，保罗他讲的话有智慧，保罗他讲的话有爱心，保罗讲的话有力量。保罗为什么讲的提摩太会听呢？因为保罗花了很多的时间来带领提摩太，他花了很多时间来跟随主，让提摩太看见他的榜样。今天我们要跟随主，教会要起来，就在乎我们在座的诸位，我们的榜样怎么样？人来到我们中间，他们看见的是爱，他们看见的是接纳，他们看见的是智慧，他们看见的是温柔，他们看见的是接纳。因为耶稣基督就是这样。我们中间如果给人家表现的，来到我们的中间，我们给人的是冷漠，我们给人家是一种批评态度或是我们没有照顾到一些人的需要你说我们都没有经过过吗？没有经过过吗？应当不是的但是我们要记得要像保罗跟提摩太的这种关系他才能够说我所说的话你统统要思想。Paul didn't say that you know, I just have a few words to say to you. I hope you remember. I hope that will leave an indelible mark in your mind. No. Paul said, think over what I say. Everything I told you is important, for the Lord will give you understanding in everything. 因为保罗得到的是从神那里得到的。他是每一件事情都从神那里得到了，所以他可以说这句话。Because Paul received everything from the Lord, that's why he can say, remember everything about what the Lord said. It's beneficial to you. If we are convinced, we have a strong conviction that the value of the Word of God, I truly believe our church will literally be a joyful place for every one of us. Even for the newcomers, they're going to sense the togetherness, just like a hymn we say. We're together to give the blessing to the Lord. We are here for the Lord because He came. And Lord Jesus Christ gave everything to us, including His own life. He suffered for us, so that we all know that to that degree of excruciating pain on the cross, we know that He loved us to the same level, same degree, the same extent. He'll never let us go our own way. So come back to the Lord. Don't just go your own way. It will be too costly. The price you pay is too much. And many times it will be to the point of no return. It will be too late. The verse 8 summarizes the whole thing. And it's 你要纪念啊，下面第八节，耶稣基督乃是大卫的后裔，他从死里复活，正合乎我所传的福音。是吗？耶稣基督是大卫的后裔，意思他是作王掌权的那一位啊。神应许亚伯拉罕在中间要出君王，应许大卫他的后裔要永远坐在宝座，没有君王可以永远坐在宝座，国度永恒无疆，乃是指的耶稣基督。所以我们今天需要只记得这件事情，我们记得很多事情又忘记了这件事情啊，怎么可能呢？ Now we need to remember one thing is very important. The Lord Jesus Christ is a descendant of a King David. Why this so important? Why we need to remember this? Because that was a promise. That was a prophecy. That was the whole package of redemption through the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, a descendant of David, the Lion of Judah. He overcome. He will save us from the hands of the enemy, Satan, and evil forces. Praise the Lord. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, and the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel. In my gospel. Apostle Paul at the end, he said, that's the only thing I felt is a good news. And because Jesus Christ, he is the overcomer. He destroyed sin and death. That's why he can be resurrected. He was raised from the dead. He has been risen.Praise the Lord! 今天我们的主他从死里复活，啊，感谢赞美主。我们下面看一下哈，很快的啊，看一，你看，啊，复习一下，啊，父亲的教导，你有教导吗？教导你的孩子，有没有在基督耶稣的恩典上刚强起来？不是别的，是这一件事情。好 ，Father, what how?Good is your teaching. How concentrated is your teaching? Well, that teaching with a focus, emphasis, and bring convergency to your children, to your children's children. Okay, second one. 意象的传递在许多人见证人面前，我教训的这件事情，你一定要交托那忠心能够教导别人的人。我们做了吗？我们交托给别人吗？我们很多人知识很多，但是他们常跟我一样，有的时候说也是不想交了。为什么不想交？因为没有人要听啊，没有人要好好的遵循，所以不要讲了。这不对的，这是一个意向的传递啊。The vision need to pass down from generation to generation.Pass on to one person to another. And what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men who will be able to teach others as well. Will teach others also. So let's just embrace that reminder. Okay, 下面生命的榜样。你有生命的榜样吗？你要和我同受苦难，好像耶稣基督的精兵。 A life example, the role model, and Paul truly want to people to share in suffering as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. Next one. 我们不被捆绑，你有被捆绑吗？凡在军中当兵的不让撒旦来控制我们，不让世界 啊的网罗把我们吸引去，让我们啊跌倒啊，是不将事物产生，好叫那招他当兵的喜悦，我们逃生的喜悦，这是非常重要的。No soldier gets entangled in civilian pursuit. Seems his aim is to please the one who enlists him. We are enlisted as a Christian soldier. Remember that. 比赛的规则上面啊，在场上要比武的时候啊，非按规矩不能得冠冕啊，所以刚才记得必须要按照规矩啊，你不可以违背啊这样的一些条例啊，你就说我喜欢这样，这样会更好，那不能得胜的啊。Competition have a rule, and we need to. You come in later. We talk about Olympic. It's over, but the athlete, is not crowned unless he compete according to the rules. Are you going to compete in the rules? The rules is to be humble and to love the Lord, love others. If we fail to love God, we failed to love our fellow man. We failed. Next one. 殷勤的果子啊，这是劳力的农夫理当先得粮食。要劳苦，但是要忍耐等候。Result of labor, it is hard work that counts.The hardworking farmers who ought to have the first share of the crops. You understand that? No need further a remind. Next, 我们要昼夜思想。昼夜思想什么事？保罗写给我们的，写给提摩太的，告诉他的，给他看见的，你所说的话，你要思想。我告诉你的话是神的话，所以要思想。你还要说出去告诉别人，也让别人思想，因为凡事主必给你聪明gain understanding is of paramount importance. Think over what I say, for the Lord will give you understanding in everything, not just a little bit here and a little bit there, everything, all inclusive. The word of God, the whole counsel of the scripture.Will equip us to be the overcomers. We are talking about overcome. Next, the last, need to be centered on Jesus Christ. It's a Christ center. 是以基督为中心的。你要纪念耶稣基督的他乃是大卫的后裔，他从死里复活，这合乎我所传的福音。Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, and the offspring of David, as preached in my gospel. We have that conviction. This is my gospel. This is your gospel. This is everything. Now quickly, we're going to see some pictures later. But before that, next. The reason for us to do that is because Jesus Christ is going to come back again.为什么我们做这些事情？因为耶稣基督的国度必然临到，在启示录第十一章第十五节里面讲到，第七位天使吹号，天上就有大声音说，世上的国成了我主和主基督的国，他要做王直到永远。 Because the Lord is going to descend from heaven, and on that day the trumpet will sound, and the loud voiceproclaim the kingdom of this world will become the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ, and he will reign forever and ever. Next one. 我们服侍他的人必会得到奖赏。那时候你们必归回，将善人和恶人、侍奉神和不侍奉神的分别出来。 Now that day will come, and the Lord of course will restore the Israel.But It's God's people, God's children. All will be stand before the Bema Seat. Of course, this could be generalized, including the Gui Huai Song. And the Lord will separate those people who will serve the Lord and those who will not serve the Lord. Next, in Revelation 22, verse 3, also say this. 在启示录里面最后的时候，仍然要讲到这个，在永恒中，众仆人、神的仆人都要侍奉他。在城里面，有什么？有羔羊是城的殿啊。那日啊，我们是耶稣基督的身体啊。到那日啊，主再来的时候啊，神啊，在他的中间啊，发现每一位都是他的仆人，都是祭司。每一位都是服侍他的。 On that day, the Lord Jesus Christ will establish the kingdom of God and into eternity. And we are going to stand there, be a part of this crowd. Not everyone is a priest. We're called to be the universal priesthood of all believers. The priest is now to preaching. The priest proclaim the word of God. The high priest, he's serving God. Also the priest serving God. Those who serve God called priests. So we are the kingdom of the priest. Understand that?And the, 神说若有人服侍我，耶稣说就当跟从我，我在哪里服侍我的人也要在哪里，若有人服侍我，父必尊重他。 May the Lord bless you, because if you serve the Lord and God will highly honor you, but you got to follow the Lord Jesus Christ. Where he was, there you will be also. AndIf you serve the Lord, our Heavenly Father will highly honor you. That's the end. We're going to see a few pictures quickly. I use this picture in the evergreens a lot. But if you didn't hear what's the most important,This will summarize just a few minutes. 很快，好，我们看下面啊，下面读圣经，请读圣经。这个一个是希伯来文，一个是希腊文。但我们今天很好啊，人家都帮我们做好了，所以我们不必读了那么多啊。我们全部都有中文的翻译的啊。好 ，Now study your Bible. Number two, pray unceasingly. 常常祷告，不住的祷告。有什么事情会比这个更重要呢？啊，来到神的面前啊，是神所悦纳的啊，神是馨香之祭。下面啊，我们必须要传扬福音啊 ，share the gospel 啊 ，with shepherd's heart 啊。If we don't have it, you know, we just need to be reminded that if people didn't share the gospel to us, still today we are lost until now. Okay, and you need to teach your children.To do the discipleship, 教导儿女，教导儿女，然后一起来做神的工作。再来，啊 ，there's nothing more important than the whole family together. Home of Christ is a family. We love each other, one another. Love people. 好，下面 ，now we have a vision to pass down from generation to generation. Remember, those are the word of God, and.Ordinance that the Lord Jesus Christ established. 神所给我们的。下面we await Christ's coming. We wait for Christ's second coming. 等候主再来。这不要都睡着了，要醒着警醒。好，下面有一些人刚好醒来This is my son. He's leaving the place he served for many years.And that's heart to say goodbye to those young people and their parents. They threw the party to them. That was just a few days ago. 几天前，我的一个儿子，他在服侍的中间，他结束了，这样的一个服侍，下面他现在去到离开美国，他离开美国，他们两个最后，下面他们去做什么？他们到台湾去，宣教去了，他有这么多年的时间，在神的话语中间受栽培造就，他预备了，愿意再一步的去学习，请为他们祷告。他学了十几年神学，最后后面，我儿啊，你要在基督耶稣的恩典上刚强起来。You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus.你在许多见证人面前听见我所教训的，你也要交托那忠心能教导别人的人。 What you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. Let's pray.父亲为父的心，像保罗要祝福他的儿子提摩太，主啊，你祝福我们基督之家的每一位在真道上面被装备的弟兄姐妹，有一天主啊，你要重用他们，主啊，你让他们忍耐等候，主啊，你让他们像是主啊，你呼召出来的基督精兵，也像是那些在场上比武的人，更像是农夫忍耐等候结实。祝你祝福他们和他们的家，祝福他们的儿女。 Our Father, we thank you for today that you allowed us to be the one passed on the legacy from one generation to anotherAnd Lord, we desire to be the Christian soldier and to be athlete. And to, like the farmer, wait for the season to come. And to reap the harvest that you so kindly provided for all of us. And Lord, may everyone here heard this message receive a blessing from the Lord.That they will be channel of blessing to many, not only in this generation, but to the generation to come. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.